What is up, Booboo Gang? So today we're gonna be reacting to 504 and God Did Freestyle official video.
Shout out to everybody worldwide. Big up, man. The world is yours.
Shout out to all y'all.
That's the new slogan. The world is yours. Mm-hmm. Cause we got people out here trying to take our world from us. You dig? Mm-hmm. So keep that. That's the new slogan.
Facts.
For 23 coming in. The world is yours. The Creator gave us this world to have dominion and to live in harmony and peace and love. And these people trying to take this joint from us over there. Mm-hmm. So the world is yours, man.
Thanks.
Don't forget that. Everywhere I put my foot is mine. America, Africa, South America, Asia is mine. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
But men and women trying to keep you from walking on this beautiful earth we got. So, you know, doing all type of crazy things. This world is crazy right now.
Thanks.
Anyway, salute to everybody worldwide, man.
Shout out to all y'all.
You know what I'm saying?
Make sure y'all hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, hit the notification bell, okay?
Dude. Big up.
You know what I'm saying?
Big up Boston, Massachusetts. Y'all in the building.
Shout out
big
to Boston.
Big up to y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Boston.
Beantown in the house. Big up to y'all, man.
Mm-hmm. So Favio. Bobby dropped a freestyle called The God Did Freestyle, which I'm guessing is from DJ Khaled's album. But he freestyled off of one of DJ Khaled's beats. So, you know what I'm saying?
Who's this? Favio Farm?
Mm-hmm. Okay. You remember who Favio is, right?
I heard some of
Big
the,
Drip.
I heard some of the stuff, but no, I'm not really into the drill scene. You know, because they be talking about doing all that, and mm-hmm. I ain't with all that. I mean, I listen to R&B. I'm real selective even in that.
Not facts.
For the most part, I don't really mess with hip hop no more. This is some old or you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
I don't you know. So let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah.
God did me.
That's chemistry, man. Let's fuck with this shit. Not everybody can do this shit. Not everybody can do this good. So, yeah. Sometimes you gotta state your facts. Sometimes you gotta say your stats. Yeah.
Yeah, 5 day. Lord forgive me for all the drilling that I did. Who was saying viral before I did? How many drill rappers came out of my crib? Yeah. Nigga, all of them. Niggas my seeds, I just water them. Serving rappers good in LA.
He said, how many drill rappers came out of my crib?
Calling them his seeds.
It's basically his son. So he's saying he started. That's a debate. You know that, right?
Yeah.
Of drill.
Who started it?
I heard that they used to call it trap before, and the UK was calling it drill.
Oh, okay.
So I heard the UK.
But trap and drill, they're similar, but they're not
but
really.
The beats is
like I feel like Future is trap. Young Thug is trap.
But the beat is. But the beats.
They're not
is
drill
different.
Rappers.
But the beat is different. But if I'm not mistaken, educate me. You know what I'm saying? I don't mind. Being educated. I'm not, you know, egotistical where I can't be educated, but I heard that drill rapping started from the UK.
That's what I heard. I don't know where.
Because they used to call it trap music in the States, but over there they call it drill or they call it grim.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Over there. And they had them, like those beats that's over there in the UK. We didn't have that over here until now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Some years back, if I'm not mistaken.
But as far as what rapper over here started drill, I don't know if it's Bobby.
So who you think? Some people say Chicago started it. That's what they say.
Yeah, when back in like Chief Keef days. But
yeah.
I don't know.
So he taking shots at dudes.
Basically.
Saying that he just saying basically
he
the father. Saying he the father.
Yeah.
I don't know if a lot of people gonna like what he's saying, you know. Anyway, go ahead.
Let's see.
Starting problems.
Let's see.
Starting problems.
This is a good conversation though. was a good conversation though.
Okay.
Lord forgive me for all the drilling that I did. Who was saying viral before I did? How many drill rappers came out of my crib? Yeah. Nigga, all of them. Niggas my seeds, I just water them. Yeah. Certain rappers gunning their Lakers, niggas extorting them. And I already beat my ops, but I'm still taunting them. And I put the biggest features on drill music. Yeah, it was a lot of drilling, but it's still music. They tryna ban us, cause niggas wanna kill to it. It wasn't fit for the radio, but they still use it. I did Drake, I did Ye, I did Nas. I did Alicia Keys, I did Mary J. Blige. I did Nicki Minaj, I went verse for verse with the top legends and survived. Nigga, I did more than the above, and I believed them when they told me it was love. But when I asked for a favor back, they act like I was bugged. I ain't saying names, but them niggas know who they was. I had platinum plaques and Grammy nobbin.
Who he talking about?
So he feeling some type of way.
He trying to clear some people out.
So he feeling some type of way that he asked for some features on certain cats and they ain't showing no love. Okay.
I wonder who he talking about. That's crazy.
He did that track with Nas. I remember him when Nas came out.
He's had a lot of legendary. Okay.
So, but he in his feelings right now. But I can kind of sympathize because when you trying to get on, people don't want to rock with you until you on. Like call somebody up for a feature. Mm-hmm. And they don't respond to you. You can understand that. Mm-hmm. You did. But guess what? But like, here's the flip side. When you get on and now you popping, now the people that didn't want to respond to you or be on your song, now they want to be on your song, now they want to be around you because you popping now.
Right.
So, but when you don't want to deal with them, they say you Hollywood. No, it's I don't forget what you did to me.
Yeah.
I'm acting the way you acted me. So it's a two way street now. So people wait till you start popping to want to deal with you instead of understanding people's come up. Everybody has a come up.
Yeah, like everybody started
at the bottom
from somewhere.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Not one person. And I don't care from business, from being an athlete, from being an actor, or whatever. Everybody has to come up.
That person probably was doing the same thing when they were trying to come
exactly.
up.
Exactly.
You know.
And people forget when people are in positions, people forget the come up.
Yeah.
Sometimes people are busy. They understand that, but. Come on, bro. You know the come up.
For real.
Don't ever forget that. Humble yourself. Keep 10 toes down.
Yeah.
You dig? They don't want to do that. So that's why I be, now you're acting Hollywood. No, I'm acting the way you treated me because when I was trying to holler at you to get a feature, it wasn't a response. I emailed you. I texted you. I DM'd you. I did all that. It wasn't a response. Now that I'm popping, now you want to roll with me.
For real.
Nah. I'm not acting Hollywood. I'm treating you the same way you treated me. Back to this boy.
And I believed them when they told me it was love. But when I asked for a favor back, they act like I was bugged. I ain't saying names, but them niggas know who they was. I had platinum plaques and Grammy nominations before an album out. It was COVID when I did Wildin' Out. Yeah, if I own it, then they get rhymed about. And I can't run into my ops cause they be hiding out. And Hope never mentioned, but I know he hit me too. Your young boy said I'm the king, he compared me to you. Nigga, that was Kanye West. I even said we want to Beyonce's best.
He talking his stuff. He talking about Say My Name.
So, what's that song? Is it fire?
No, What's My Name? Say My Name. The one that he did with Queen and Koi. It was on his album.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Did we react to that? I think we react to that.
Nah.
Are we there?
Nah. I think I just played it around you, for you.
Your young boy said I'm the king, he compared me to you. Nigga, that was Kanye West. I even said we wanna Beyonce's best. Even Beyonce said Demon Time. Catalan called me for the album, that hurt me inside. On my album, he did a skit called God Did. Then dropped the album called God Did. Yeah, like is this pain really worth the fame? We almost lost TJ, is it worth them chains?
DJ Khaled. To me, I don't like. How can I put it? I don't hate him, but I don't like him because he always wants the big name features. He never wanna deal with artists that's not as big. He always wanna do a song with Jay-Z, with Drake, with Beyonce. Like he always want the big acts, mm-hmm. but don't wanna work with artists maybe like him. Even his old artist that's no longer with him is Ace Hood. That, you know what I'm saying? Like, help other artists out, bro.
His album wasn't even that good.
Yeah, exactly, because
I listened to it. It was
like he always trying to get these big features. He trying to
put the whole industry on one song. Yeah, and like, expects it to just like sound like, perfect, like, yeah, and blow up.
Like, that's why I don't really like him like that. It's like, give other artists a chance that's hungry, that's in the streets. Give them a chance.
Yeah.
But he's trying to rub shoulders with all the top.
Yo, he's not like a K Slay.
Yeah, he's not. He's not like a K Slay, a Flex.
Or
you know what I'm saying?
Like Metro Boomin, like the dudes that just do projects with mad artists. Like he's not artists. Like one
he's
of
not
those.
Like that. He's about trying to rub his shoulders with the so called elite artists. And they old anyway. They older.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Get with some of the young. Know what I mean? Like all the young artists that's young right now. Get with some of them.
Yeah.
Like, stop trying to, like, come on, bro.
That's crazy.
Mm. Freaking break with that.
Ain't really worth the fame. We almost lost TJ. Is it worth them chains?
Yeah.
Nigga, I don't even hurt the same. Bought Mace back to life. Now that's $1 million worth of game.
Oh.
That nigga lied.
Go back.
He said, because Mace went on $1 million worth of game talking about the contract.
Yeah.
So they were
talking about the 5,000 and all that.
So he said he brought Mace back alive, basically saying, without going on there, and nobody ran about Mace.
I mean, he not lying. Like, we not.
Man, Mace is a confused dude, man. One day he wanted to be a pastor, then he wanted to be a rapper, then he back to being a pastor, now he wanted to be a rapper. It's like, bro, make up your mind. You can't play two sides of the fence. Either you're rolling with God or you're rolling with the world, bro.
No,
like, come on, bro. Like, cut it out, bro. Like that's just crazy, bro.
That is crazy.
You know what I mean? That's crazy.
Mm-mm.
I'm called God dead. Yeah. Like, is this pain really worth the fame? We almost lost TJ. Is it worth them chains?
Yeah.
Nigga, I don't even hurt the same. Bought Mace back to life. Now that's $1 million worth of game. That nigga lied. Talking about I'm scared of who? Nigga, you fried. He ain't even wanna say it. I see it in his eyes, and you still hate Diddy, so how I'm letting that shit slide? Who else made a New York anthem? Yeah, Hope did. JD can never be for me, I bailed him out of a old bed. I done traveled the whole globe, kid. New York City feel like my old crib. Huh, and I'm just getting started. Who else drop brakes on the red carpet? Nigga, do what I want. He not feeling me, niggas a munch. And what they did in some years took me some.
That freaking song, that freaking munch joint.
They wanted you to react to that, but like, Pop's already watched it off camera, so can't react to that. But,
I don't want to hear about no girl tomorrow. She want to do the eat day. I don't want to hear all that nonsense, bro. What the hell about that?
Oh, man.
Like, a lot of y'all females, we be talking about y'all want dudes going on there. Man, please, bro. Mm. Going out there. So some of y'all got the, you know.
Nah, but munch don't mean that though. Munch don't mean like.
So what do you mean?
You going down on her? That means like, I don't know how to put it. Like, I don't know how to put it.
Anyway,
a munch is like the male version of like a F boy, kind of in a way.
Anyway.
But it's deeper than that though.
Okay, back to the
boy. Who else dropped brakes on the red carpet? Nigga, do what I want. He not feeling me. Niggas a munch. And what they did in some years took me some months. Give me my credit, nigga. Enough is enough. And not just that, I'm out of a couple of stuff. They don't let me perform no awards or none of the stuff. The Glock boys in the building tonight. Boy in the feeling is nice. Look, he get paid twice if he kill him tonight. As if he kill him. Yeah. I heard the opps say it's up with me. Even your daddy don't wanna fuck with me.
Damn.
Look, even your daddy falling in love with me.
Damn.
Look, yeah, even your body coming to bump with me. Yeah.
Yeah, nigga. Thought it was hard, nigga.
So he's in the gang or something?
Yeah, he Crip.
Oh. So he's on. You know, a lot of people probably don't like what he said.
Yeah.
Well, he don't care.
Right, he had to set the record straight.
Right, he's gonna throw a lot of drama. Didn't he, like, something happened to him?
Oh, you talking about when he got shot?
So it was him.
Yeah. That was, like, months back, though.
So he got shot. You know?
Yeah, he got shot.
Hey, be careful, baby.
Then he be having drama with his baby moms.
But,
yeah, man.
Nah, it is. That's why you don't have baby moms.
But I mean, she live with him, so.
Still.
He take care of her.
Of course he take care of her. She ain't gonna take care of herself.
I mean, at this point.
Well, I mean, man, women always, all the time, talking about this, that, and third. But if you can't take care of yourself, then why you want somebody to take care of you? Mm-hmm. I don't understand that. Anyway.
Shout out to Fabi. Mm-hmm. Leave y'all thoughts down below on the track.
What y'all think? Educate me on who started drill. Where did it start from? Where did it come from? Who was the first one that started all this drill music or trap music, whatever y'all want to call it? Who's the pioneers?
But I just think that like
of the game.
Fabi gotta.
Some people gonna sit here and
bring up Pop.
Yeah, but people was doing that before Pop Smoke though.
Yeah, I know that, but a lot of the young dudes after Pop is from Pop.
Future was doing that all that.
Pop is a big inspiration to the drill scene. So.
Yeah, but so is Chief Keeping Them.
Yeah.
Chief Keeping Them is big in the drill scene too. But, so I mean, what you saying?
Like, I'm talking about strictly New York though.
Yeah, but like in New York, because you know why? Because New York wasn't doing that. New York was just like New York had the boom bat beats and it was bars. We never, but the new generation came up. Probably came up off of guys like Future, Chief Keef, and all them cats when they was coming up. Mm-hmm. And then New York drill, you know what I mean, came into existence through that. But
yeah,
if it was the old way, then it would be nothing but lyrical rappers in New York City right now. Mm-hmm. If New York never picked up the whole drill stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Facts. Sure. But I don't know, Fabio being the king of that.
He said the father.
Yeah, the father of that. I don't know.
Y'all tell us.
I don't know.
It don't even matter.
Make sure y'all subscribe. Smash the like button. Pops can care less.
Exactly. Peace be out.
Peace out.